Welcome back to Montana This Morning. The time is 6:48. A beautiful view of the Magic City on this Monday morning. Makes it feel like, oh, this Monday isn't so bad. Usually you have a case of the Mondays, but nice sunshine, clear sky gets you in a good mood. Let's go ahead now and get started with the day's news. A volcano in Guatemala has erupted for the second time this year, killing more than two dozen people and injuring hundreds more. The eruption spewed smoke nearly 4 miles into the sky and covered local villages in ash. Thousands of people have been evacuated. Also in this morning's headlines, President Trump's personal attorney says his legal team would fight any attempt to have the president testify before a grand jury in the Russia investigation. Rudy Giuliani also told the Sunday talk shows that he believes the president does have the power to pardon himself, but it would probably lead to immediate impeachment. Meanwhile, a profile in Sunday's New York Times hints Donald Trump Jr. is making his way to Montana. In a tweet Sunday morning, Trump Jr. shared the article with the caption, "See you soon, John, hashtag MAGA." The article is about Montana Senior Senator John Tester and how he isn't sweating President Trump's planned summertime blitz against Democrats in a campaign tour. Tester is running unopposed in the June primary. Four Republicans are vying for the opportunity to face him in the November election, including Matt Rosendale, Russ Fagg, Troy Downing, and Al Olszewski. Here in Billings, last week's hit and run that severely injured a pedestrian has turned fatal. Just last week, Tuesday, a 20-year-old man was struck by a car in a hit and run while walking down 8th Street West near Alderson. Since then, 22-year-old Tesha Dawn Williams has been charged with 3 felonies and 2 misdemeanors, including negligent vehicular assault. Billings police confirmed the man died over the weekend, with Montana Highway Patrol listing the incident as a fatality just last night. Court documents state the victim, identified as SB, was thrown several feet when he was struck by Williams' car. The suspect was located by a MSU Billings police officer about 2 miles away, driving eastbound in a westbound lane. Arresting officers say her car's windshield was smashed and there was blood on the bumper. Her BAC was almost 3 times the legal driving limit. We'll continue to follow this case as upgraded charges for the victim's death can be expected. Now we go to Great Falls, where 6 people are hospitalized after a crash that involved 2 cars and 4 motorcycles. It happened Sunday afternoon on Vaughn, south of Frontage Road. A car was making a left-hand turn when a second vehicle came up behind and rear-ended the car. The car was then pushed out into the road and hit the 4 motorcycles coming from the opposite direction. 6 people were injured and taken to the hospital. Their conditions range from minor to serious. So far, no fatalities have been reported. Near Augusta, a hiker becomes an example on the importance of being well prepared while heading out into the wilderness. A 23-year-old Havre area man contacted authorities Saturday to let them know he was lost. He didn't have any injuries and he had enough supplies for an overnight stay. He was located and rescued Sunday morning by Two Bear Air and the Lewis and Clark Search and Rescue Team. The ground team was delayed by snow. The Lewis and Clark County Sheriff's Office reminds everyone conditions can be deceiving this time of year. Well, Billings was the gathering place for the regional convention of Jehovah's Witnesses. The 3-day event attracted close to 3,500 church members. The region includes Montana, along with the northern part of Wyoming and the western parts of North and South Dakota. The theme of all Jehovah's conventions is Be Courageous.
Each and every one of us, I mean, we have problems, we have difficulties, we have things that cause us anxiety. And through coming to a convention such as this, we get the encouragement from God's Word, His counsel that helps us then to build our faith so that we can continue to be courageous and continue on.
The Regional Convention of Jehovah's Witnesses has been held in Billings since 1974. Elsewhere, for 27 years, the Helping Hands Poker Run has helped finance medical bills for children in need. Sunday in Billings, hundreds of bikers showed up to the 27th annual Poker Run to support this year's child, Connor. Connor has retinal cancer, a cancer of the eye, making it difficult to see. His parents, Julie and Eric, have found a doctor in New York that can perform a different type of chemotherapy to hopefully increase Connor's chances of getting better. Sunday's participants in the poker run hope to get him there by raising money. President and General of Helping Hands, Billy Welk, says the secret to 27 years of poker run success is to make sure people have fun.
Yeah, and everybody loves it. There's a ton of people that come even in cars, not just bikes. We try to set it up so everything goes smoothly, so everybody that goes enjoys the day, and everybody that, you know, that where they end up or where they start, like the red door, everybody like has a good time. So try to make it smooth and easy so then everybody leaves and they're like, yes, let's do it again.
To stay in the know about the dates and times for next year's run, visit Helping Hands Poker Run on Facebook.